In this video, we continue with the design of the mathematical model. We have seen that this mathematical model is composed of two parts, the functional model and the stochastic model. Now, we also have been introduced to the main characters which act in the functional model, discussed in the previous video. So, we can now focus on connecting the elements in the functional model. Let's repeat the overview of these elements. I presume you now know of our standard notation for the observables, the unknowns, the errors, and the function connecting the unknowns and the observables. We will now connect them together in the model of observation equations. I will do this first in an abstract sense, in which we have three observables and two unknowns connected via a linear model. In a perfect world, observations do not contain any errors. We can then write the three observables in a vector and relate them to the two unknowns also in a vector. The observable vector has dimensions 3 by 1, and the vector of unknowns is 2 by 1. These must then be connected by a matrix with three rows and two columns. We call this the design matrix. This is our default Y is AX model. Now, in reality, the world is not perfect, and observations are always contaminated by noise or errors. In other words, this model cannot be correct. There is another problem with this particular model. On the left-hand side of the equality sign, the parameters are stochastic, as you can see from the line under the symbols. However, on the right-hand side of the equality sign, all parameters are deterministic. Obviously, this is impossible. The equality sign forces the left-hand side and the right-hand side to be equal, so they are either both deterministic or they are both stochastic, but they cannot have a different nature. We can fix this problem by adding the errors to the equation. The errors are associated to each individual measurement, and therefore the vector has the same size as the vector of observables. Note that the equation is now in balance. Both on the left-hand side and on the right-hand side, the parameters are stochastic. What can we say about the errors? We know that they are stochastic variables, and therefore they can take any value from the probability distribution that describes them. However, the whole idea of making good measurements implies that we can expect that the value of the error should be zero. In other words, if we would need to make a best guess, it would always be best to assume that the errors are zero. We can write this in a mathematical solid way by using the so-called expectation operator. We expect the errors to have a zero mean distribution. This means that we expect the errors to be all zero. This is denoted in this way. The letter E, in combination with the curly brackets, represents the expectation operator, and it will be a standard part of our functional model of observation equations. If we can write the expectation of the errors in this way, it is easy to find an equivalent expression for the expectation of the observables. Let's have a look. If we use the expectation operator on the left-hand side of the equation, we should use it on the right-hand side as well. Since the expectation operator is only applicable on stochastic variables, we apply it to the vector of errors. And as we just saw that this expectation is equal to zero, we can then remove this part of the equation. So, to summarize, we can write an alternative expression for the model of observation equations using the expectation operator. If we evaluate whether this equation is in balance, we find that the right-hand side of the equation is deterministic, and therefore the left-hand side needs to be deterministic too. Apparently, the expectation operator converts a stochastic vector into a deterministic vector. So, in summary, what we have demonstrated in this lecture is that there are two ways to express the functional model in the model of observation equations. The first expression denotes the error vector explicitly, and the second expression uses the expectation operator. Both are valid expressions. We can write these models in a more generic sense, as indicated here. The vectors in this expression are of arbitrary length. In this video, we explained how we can denote the functional relation between the observations and the unknowns in a generic mathematical form. With this theory, we can now start practicing.